The question of this debate is how do we find the right balance in a very fragile state and with people from multinational, multi-social, multi-ideologies, how do you maintain this state that has no other option but still living together? How do you make it that people are less worse off? Because we think that under their model, people are going to be more worse off. If you're the 45% of secular residents of the city of Beit Shemesh, you are going to live a really hellish life. If you are only going to maintain the status quo, which was a compromise to begin with, and it's still a compromise, you're not going to be extremely unhappy, as Al portrayed it by explaining it there. It's only extremely unhappy. Few rebuttals, and then I'm going to explain how do we make decisions in places as fragile as Israel, why specifically the status quo is the right way to maintain our society, and how it's going to benefit the minority of the minorities. So first, few answers. So I said, yeah, but Judaism here is kind of, you know, it's a box with chocolates and each one can subscribe into every belief. To which you say, yes, of course, you can subscribe to each belief that you have, but because we live in such a fragile state, so the laws should find a compromise, like any other law. And you're saying you can subscribe to anything you believe, but the laws have to be, at the end of the day, they have to be something particular, not now. Then she said, the lack of discourse is the status quo now. Few answers to that. A, we know it's kind of the status quo now. We don't need to make it even worse. We have the same lack of discourse, the same dispute with Arabs in Israel, and we think still like that we need to live together. This is why we need to have a discourse, we need to have channels of communication, and we don't want people to feel totally alienated. Second of all, we say, you know, we would like to know that if under your law, to a certain extent, we should allow, let's say, villages in the north that want to apply Sharia laws. Obviously, you will say, oh, Sharia laws, yeah, they are terrible, so it's illiberal, so we understand. But not exactly, you know, stoning women, but just, you know, not allowing women to get married at the age of 16, age of consent, things like that, because we're saying this is exactly how we fight for liberty.
On the status quo, sir.
No, because we allow laws that we know they don't have too much impact on people. Then she said about the minority of the minorities, oh, listen, that's a very nice solution. She can just move from Bat Yam, move from Jerusalem, go to Tel Aviv. This is how it goes here. People have complex identities. Meaning, I can be an Orthodox person living in Jerusalem. I can have the sexual orientation of a gay, and I don't have the option to leave my community. And this is what Elon was talking with you about. We want the gay kid in Jerusalem to have the pride, which is by the status quo allowed, to have the LGBT pride, knowing that he has a place to consult with. And if you just leave Jerusalem, and very soon you're going to have 51% majority of ultra-Orthodox people, then this kid will have no one, because Jerusalem forever will be a religious town where any LGBT activity is going to be disallowed. And this is not what we want to achieve. Finally, her point was that people perceive Judaism as a dichotomy today, and either you opt in, either you opt out. And we're saying, again, we understand, we accept the harm that people feel unhappy when they can't, Michael can't marry Cohen, we know how it's painful for him, right? But still we say, it's a price that we are willing to pay in order to get social cohesion, in order to save the minority of the minorities, and especially in order to make sure that people are worse off just a bit and not too much. Moving on to my point, how do we make decisions in very fragile places like Israel? So we say, if each part feels that he loses, and we know that that's the case in Israel, right? We know that people in Jerusalem are appalled by the mere thought of having the pride parade in the street of Yafo or right here in King Charles Street. We know that the LGBT community is furious about the fact that people can get married. And we say, that's fine, guys. That's the definition of a compromise. This is how we get things together. Now, what do we have to say here? That why specifically in Israel is it so detrimental? Because we say, when countries become too inclusive, when areas become too exclusive towards citizens that are not the majority of that areas, this is when we get the backlash. This is why illiberal countries like Syria and Iraq failed to become states, when the Sunni excluded the Shia and when the Alawis excluded anyone else. If you want an example of a liberal country, this is what happened to Ireland, where just the Protestants had to have this semi-state, semi-city, Northern Ireland. And we'll say, in Israel, that's not something that we can actually allow. Why is that? So, first of all, let's establish the fact that we do have a compromise. So I gave a few examples, a few more. So we're saying, although I can't marry as a gay person, I can still have the option to party as a gay person, I still have the option to have pride parades. I say, not now. Although I don't have the option to display food, not kosher food in Passover, I can still eat it anywhere I want. And we're saying, you know what? This is exactly the compromise here.
On that.
Not that. Now, why is it specifically detrimental in Israel? That's the next page. Right. A, Mike, we have mixed populations in Israel. Even if when we don't have mixed populations, like example, the majority of the Arab population is concentrated in the north, we're still kind of thinking of allowing them an autonomy as something very complex. Why is that? So A, because we have same infrastructure, right? We use the same roads. Meaning, how would you allow the city of Bat Yam to have public transportation? Because you know Gush Dan is like basically one big metropolitan, one very big complex. So now, moreover, we say, and this is more important, you have mixed populations in the cities. Meaning that the 45% of the people of Beit Shemesh will be totally alienated. And this is real, I'm extremely, extremely happy, Yael, not now, because those people will not be allowed to drive on Shabbat. We want our own brothers to be able to come to competitions. Finally, before that I will take Mike.
Okay, not being able to marry the person I regard as the love of my life affects everything about me. I'm not comforted by the fact that I can go to great after parties.
So, exactly that. We have the compromise for you, Mike. You can go outside, you can have a civic union with people that you're not allowed religiously to marry with, you can go to Greece, to Cyprus. I know that's a price to pay, but that's a price that we are willing to pay in order to get things together. So we say the mixed populations in the cities will be extremely unhappy because those people will feel like they're really worse off. And finally, we're saying, why now? Because we're saying that there's a few things about Israeli specifically now. We know that the hatred between religious and non-religious is going. Things like Chok Yair Lapid, where you have to draft ultra-Orthodox people, we think those are the things that are extremely sensitive in Israel. When this resolution is going to pass, this is when things will get really touchy. Because this is when people will feel they have nothing to do with the city of Jerusalem. This is when people will actually think about the very unlikely scenario of, you know, immigrating from cities to cities. This is a damage that we're not willing to tolerate. We don't think it's really a fair option for many people in Jerusalem to leave everything out because Jerusalem has become, for now and forever, religious. And this is something that we're not willing to take. You can go out to Greece, you can marry here, the state will recognize you to a certain extent, but people, hundreds of thousands of secular people in Jerusalem don't have the option to opt out and move to Tel Aviv. It will be quite crowded, no parking. Thank you.